Blender 4.2 with EEVEE Next is finally coming out these days, but how good is it really? Can it replace cycles? And what problems and workarounds are currently there? Here's everything you have to know.
So let's start with a simple example. The biggest problem with the previous EEVEE version was that it didn't support ray tracing, so we couldn't have global illumination. That means that the light can't bounce on the different objects. So like here, we have a light source and it hits the object, but only the parts that are directly hit from the light are lighted, and the rest of it is just black. So we don't have indirect light here. And what we can do now is we go to EEVEE and just activate ray tracing. And now, as you can see, we also have our indirect light and it already looks way better. And if I now move the light, then as you can see, the light bounces are working correctly and in real time, what is pretty nice. But now we come to the first problem. It's not real path tracing like cycles. It's green space ray tracing. And that means that only the objects that are currently in the frame can reflect light. So for example, if I go to the left, then as you can see, this wall doesn't reflect light anymore. The same problem if I go to the right side. So especially for animations, this can be a huge problem. And this also affects the light sources itself, so if the light isn't in the frame anymore, then you won't get any indirect light from it. The same problem also with reflections. As long as the objects are also in the frame, everything works. But now if I go to the left side, and the backside of the barbershop isn't visible in the frame, then it's also not visible in the reflection. Yeah, only if I go here now to the left so that the reflection is here again and in the frame, then it works. Here's another good example how important global illumination is. So basically we only have a light source here which comes from the top and goes in this direction. And if I now deactivate the ray tracing, then we only see the direct light but no indirect light, so everything is just black beside this little part. But here's the same problem, if I move forward and less of the wall is visible in the frame, then also less of the wall can reflect light, so everything gets darker. Okay, but now to the things we can improve. The first thing would be to crank up the samples a bit. So for the viewport I would set it to 64 for example, so that the image isn't so noisy anymore, and activate jittered shadows for more smooth and better shadows. Under render I would also crank this a bit up, and here under shadows I would also crank up the rays a bit like this, and then here we don't have to touch anything. And under ray tracing, here the resolution is very important. So as you can see, the resolution determines the number of rays per pixel. Higher resolution uses more memory. So you always have to weigh up between more memory usage and more correct light. And keep in mind that this setting is also very important for the quality of reflections, for example. So in my case, I set it to 1:1 because I have enough memory. And then under fast GI approximation, you can set the resolution for the indirect light separately. So I also set it to 1:1 and I increase the rays a bit. Especially for reflections, I would also crank up the precision. So look at the mirror, and if I crank it up, then as you can see, it's more clear. Last but not least, we could also crank up the volume resolution a bit, but in this case it's not really necessary because we don't have any volumes in the scene, but yeah. Then we are done with the basic setup and we can proceed further. The first thing I noticed is that on EEVEE Next most glasses aren't transparent, and that's because of a specific setting you have to change first for every material. So just select it, go under the material properties, settings, surface, and set the render method to divert and activate ray trace transmission. And then as you can see, it's transparent. But yeah, the resolution is not perfect. You can affect it by the screen trace resolution. For example, if I set it to 1.4, it's even worse. And yeah, even with 1.1, it's not perfect, but it's the best I could get. If you have any ideas for improvement, then please write it in the comments below. Just to show you the difference, here's how it looks like in cycles. So yeah, with denoising, it's way more clear. Also keep in mind, if you activate ray trace transmission, then the object also disappears in reflections. And yeah, that's a little problem. Another big problem I faced and also heard from others, that if you crank up the screen trace resolution or other settings higher, then it can take up to twice the RAM cycles would need for the same scene. So it's something you have to be aware of. I hope that will be improved in the future. Also, the compilation of the shaders if you open a new scene still takes quite long, but you can improve the speed a bit if you go into the preferences and then under system, you now have the ability to crank up the max shader compilation subprocesses so that more than one shader can be compiled simultaneously. It depends on how many treats your CPU has. In my case, I have 16 treats, so I can crank it up to 16. And it's important to know that you always have to connect a value node to the new thickness input of the material output so that the glass works correctly. Normally, you don't have to do anything here. Blender adds this automatically, but if you ever should face problems, then it can be due to this. So for example, if I remove the connection, then as you can see, it's just black. Now let's go to the volumes, because what is very cool that you can get with EEVEE, very fast, good looking volumetrics, which is very compute intense with cycles. So I have a basic fog domain here, and if I activate it, then we can already see our light ray coming down. And if I now move the light rotation, then as you can see, it moves with it. Yeah, but it's a bit unsharp, so we can crank up the volume resolution here. And then as you can see, it's sharper. Or like here, where we only have a sunlight and a basic volume shader. One thing that you will notice when you're using an HDRI for the background, that the light of the HDRI doesn't cast shadows of the object. So for example, the trees here, we don't see any shadows of it on the ground. And what you can do here is just go to the world settings, then settings, sun, and activate shadows. And now we can also see the shadows of the trees. But now let's come to one of the biggest improvements in EEVEE Next. EEVEE now supports shader displacements. That means you don't have to switch to cycles anymore to get a real displacement. And this is so useful and also pretty fast. But unfortunately, we will have to say goodbye to EEVEE's built-in bloom function, which I found pretty useful earlier. In EEVEE Next, we don't have this option anymore. But you could go to the compositing and add a glare node. And then as you can see, we now have a bloom option here and you could use this one instead.
So how good is EEVEE Next in comparison to cycles?
Here's the barbershop first rendered in cycles. And now in EEVEE Next.
And yeah, there's still a big difference. I cranked up all the resolution and render settings, but in a room like this with all the mirrors and other stuff, it just can't hold up with cycles because of the problems we discussed earlier. Also, the materials just don't look as realistic as in cycles. What's also interesting that the depth of field doesn't seem as accurate in EEVEE Next as in cycles. So if you look at the cupboard in the background, then you can see in EEVEE Next it's more clear than it should be. But I also want to say that if you optimize a scene directly for EEVEE Next, I'm sure you can make it more realistic than this. But these examples are to show you that in most cases, you can't just take your cycle scene, crank up the render settings a bit and render it with EEVEE Next. Then oftentimes you will be probably disappointed. Especially more simple materials can quite look the same on EEVEE Next as in cycles.
Another big problem is that EEVEE Next still has some flickering in many animations, with noisy reflections and inaccurate refractions, how the YouTuber Pixels and Polygons showed, so check also out his comparison video.
Is it as good as Lumen from Unreal? Not really, EEVEE Next just uses screen space ray tracing. Lumen uses cone tracing, which is another form of ray tracing with more benefits. EEVEE Next is also slower, depending on your hardware it takes up to 1 minute to render a frame. But this is the first version and it's already a big improvement to EEVEE. If you don't have too much camera movements in your animation, then it can work quite well with good looking global illumination. And the ability of having real-time shader displacement is also just incredible. So what's your opinion about it? Please write it in the comments below and then I'll see you next time.